All right, this section's topic is finding limits graphically. And if you notice here, I have a function given to us. It's a piecewise function, which simply means that it's made up of two different functions. F of x is equal to x, and f of x is equal to x whenever x does not equal 2. And realize the other part of this is f of x is equal to 3 whenever x does equal to 2. So simply what that means is if you're going to evaluate this function, just recall for this function, if you wanted to say find f of 4, what does that tell us? Well, that means we look over here, x, in other words, the 4 does not equal 2, so that means we would simply plug the 4 into the top part of the function. So therefore, f of 4 equals plug 4 in for x, so therefore your answer is 4. And on the other side, if we said what is f of 1, well, once again, 1 does not equal 2, so we would plug the 1 in for the x, so therefore f of 1 equals 1. Now, what happens though if we want to find f of 2? Well, here, x is equal to 2, so now we have x doesn't equal to 2, so that means we're going to take the 2, we're not going to plug it in for x because x equals 2. So that means if x is equal to 2, we have to plug it into the bottom part of the function, the second part of our piecewise function, which tells us here f of x is equal to 3. So f of 2 then is going to be equal to 3. So remember, when you're calculating these piecewise functions, you're looking at your restraint over here on the side. If x doesn't equal to 2, you're going to plug it into the top part. If x does equal to 2, we're going to plug it into the bottom part. So basically, this function says f of x is always x unless you're plugging a number in that is equal to 2. So anytime you plug 2 in, your answer is simply going to be 3. And if we look at the graph over here on the left, you'll see that basically we know f of x equals x. If you recall, that's your identity function basically. Except for now, though, we've defined when x is 2, your y value is going to be 3. So what we've done is we've taken where x is equal to 2, we've taken this part of the graph out and left a hole and redefined this value of 2 up here to be 3, creating this piecewise function. So in other words, if we would have simply had f of x equals x, then that means we would have simply had this line here without any holes in the graph. But what we've done is we've redefined f of x equals x and says, well, this function is going to always be f of x equals x except for when x is equal to 2. Therefore, giving us a hole in the graph and taking that point and moving up here to where the y value is 3. So how do we calculate the limit of this piecewise function? Well, if we look at this graphically, again, remember we're looking at what's happening to the left. So if we're looking at the limit of f of x as x approaches 1, what's happening as we approach 1 from the left and from the right? So if we go up here, as we get closer, for example, if we're approaching from the left, I can actually say, well, if we pick this value here, this may be 1/2. And if we go up and we go over, and then if we get a little bit closer to 1, we'll go up to the graph, we'll go over. And you can see here, as we get closer to 1, what is the y value approaching? Our y value is approaching 1. Well, the same thing happens here. If we say pick 1.5 and I go up to the graph and we go over, and if I get a little bit closer, maybe I pick 1.25, 1.25, we go up and we go over, and maybe we get even closer, let's say 1.1. Notice what's happening. We're getting closer and closer to 1. So therefore, the limit of this function as x approaches 1 from the left and from the right, we're approaching the value of 1. And remember, when you're finding the limit, you're finding as this x value approaches 1, what is the y value approaching? All right, so we want to look at the same function, but now we want to look at what is the limit of the function as x approaches 2. Well, if we're approaching 2, now we're going to approach 2 from the left and 2 from the right. And up here on the graph, you can tell that if we're approaching 2 from the left and 2 from the right, you're saying, well, wait a second, there's a hole in the graph. And you're going to say, well, we know that the function, if we define the function at 2, we know the actual function over here is equal to 3. Now, keep in mind, with our limit, we don't care what happens at 2. Okay, let me say that again. We don't care what happens to the function at 2. We're concerned what happens as we get extremely close to 2. As we get extremely close to 2, what's happening to our y value? So again, if we approach this, as we get closer and closer to 2 from the left and from the right, what is our y value approaching? Okay, if you said 2, you are correct. So therefore, the limit here, as we get closer and closer to 2, our y value is still approaching 2. Even though the function is defined to be equal to 3, again, we're only concerned what happens as we get extremely close to that number. All right, let's look at another example. Here we have our function. It's defined as the absolute value of x divided by x. And over here, we have the graph of our function, which would look something like this, where we would have this here. And we want to calculate what's the limit of f of x as x approaches 2. Well, here's 2. We have 2 here on the x-axis. So what's happening as we approach 2 from the left and 2 from the right? Now you may find it helpful to go up here to the graph. As we approach 2, if you follow along the graph here, what's happening as we approach 2 from the left and 2 from the right? What is your y value approaching? Well, if you notice, our graph here is just a straight horizontal line. So all of these values, your y value is always 1. So as we approach 1.5 or 1 3/4, or you say 1.5, 1.75, your y value is 1. And if we get closer and closer, so therefore your limit, as we get closer and closer to 2, your limit's going to be equal to 1. Now, what happens if we want to find the limit f of x as x approaches negative 3? Well, if we locate over here, we have our negative 3. And if we approach negative 3 from the left and negative 3 from the right, now we're looking at the part of the graph that's down here at the bottom. And if you notice, we again have a horizontal straight line. And as we approach negative 3 from the left and right, the y value is consistently or constantly equal to negative 1. So that would be your limit. Now, if you notice the third example I have here at the bottom, it says, what's the limit of the function as x approaches 0? Well, that means we want to look at what happens as we approach 0. Well, if we approach 0 from the left, and maybe I should look down here, the graph is at the bottom. As we approach 0 from the left, what is our y value approaching? Well, clearly, if we get closer and closer to 0, our y value is approaching a negative 1. Now, what happens if we approach 0 from the right? And if we go up here to where the graph is located, if we approach this from the right, our y value is approaching a positive 1. So if you notice here, from the left, we end up with a negative 1, and from the right, we end up with a positive 1. Now, make note of this. This is one of the cases where, notice from the left and right, we're approaching two different numbers. In order for your limit to exist, you must be approaching the same number. So, what happens here is we say that the limit does not exist. Okay, so there's your answer. It does not exist. And from now on, you'll notice I'll use the abbreviation DNE to represent does not exist. Okay, so this is one of the cases where your limit does not exist simply because you're approaching two different numbers. Okay, in order for your limit to exist, you must be approaching one single number. All right, for our next example here, we have a trig function, f of x equals sine of 1 divided by x. And over here, clearly, just for emphasis, we know x can't be 0 because we'd have 0 in the denominator. And we want to find the limit of this function as x approaches 0. Well, if you look over here at this graph, kind of a crazy looking graph, if you notice, the graph starts out going up and down, and as we get closer and closer to 0 here, what's happening to our values? Well, you'll notice the graph starts going back and forth between negative 1 and positive 1. So here, your graph is oscillating back and forth again between two different numbers, so once again, your limit does not exist. Okay, again, from the left and right, you have to be approaching one single number in order for it to exist. All right, the next example here we have is the function 1 over x minus 2. And we know that if we look here, if you were to graph this function, we have a split in the graph. In other words, here we end up with a vertical asymptote at x equals 2. And that's because if we look at the function, if x is 2, we have 0 in the denominator, which gives us the function to be undefined. If we want to find what's the limit of this function, and I want to change this, the limit of the function as x approaches 2. Well, we know, once again, if I said, what is f of 2? We know that we would get 1 over 2 minus 2, which is 1 over 0, and we know that is undefined. But the question we're asking is, what is the limit? In other words, what is the limit of this function that x approaches 2, again, from the left and from the right? Well, if you notice, if we approach from the left, the graph is going down over here. The graph is going down, and what's happening to your y values? Well, your y values are continuing to get smaller, so it's approaching negative infinity. If we approach 2 from the right, what's happening to your graph? As we get closer to 2, the graph here is going up, and it's approaching positive infinity. And if you notice here, our limit is not approaching a single number. It's either constantly getting smaller or getting extremely large. So once again, this is another situation in which your limit does not exist. Okay, so if we quickly review here, graphically, all you have to do is look at finding the limit, look from the left and from the right, and what number are you approaching? And there's three main categories where your limit does not exist. The first one here we looked at is if you approach a number from the left and from the right, and you approach two different values, just like we did here, from the left and right, we had two different values, your limit does not exist. Or down here, if your graph is oscillating between two different values, your limit does not exist. And the third situation is, anytime you have a split in the graph, where your graph is what they call increasing or decreasing without bound, which simply means your graph is going to infinity or negative infinity, your limit does not exist.